Alright guys, in one of my last videos you saw how I modified this small buck converter to look like a mini adjustable power supply by adding a small voltmeter and a small heatsink with a cooling fan to reduce the heat, and it's working really nice. But the laptop charger that I'm using to run this thing was getting too hot when I draw maximum current from it. And the only way to cool down the adapter is to remove the upper plastic case and connect them together in a same box, so the cooling fan can also absorb the heat from the charger and it will be exhausted. But I'm not going to restore this little thing, it may be useful for the other projects. So in this video, I'm going to make a small adjustable power supply by using two buck converters. One is for the constant 5 volt that goes to the USB socket, and the other is to adjust the output voltage. So we need a bigger heatsink for that, and I already made a few holes to avoid short circuits by connecting the circuit on it. And as always, don't forget to remove the double sided PCB from the other side of the board and also the upper layer, so it can able to transfer the heat more quickly to the heatsink. Before getting started, I want to make this power supply as small as possible. So later I got this small adapter from Asus, and it was very small, but it produced the same current as the normal ones. So firstly, I need to make a perfect rectangular box to put all the things inside. So I started cutting this acrylic glass into small pieces for the input and the outlet, and I also made a few holes for the fan where the air will be exhausted from here. I connected them all together by using an instant glue. Then I installed the adapter circuit inside with a bond fix glue, and I used some more glue at the socket so it won't come out when we pull out the cord. Then I connected the USB socket, DC jack socket and a small voltmeter, a slight switch for the voltmeter and a 7812 regulator IC to give the constant 12 volt to the cooling fan through the small switch, and as well as to power the small voltmeter. The measuring wire of the voltmeter was connected to the main pin of the slide switch, and the other two terminals will be connected to the output of the both converter so that we can see the voltage of the both modules just by sliding the switch. Here I connected the both modules on the heatsink by using some thermal paste and installed it inside. The schematic is so simple. The main positive and negative wires of the adapter circuit was directly connected to the input of the both converters and also to the DC socket and regulator IC, so everything was connected in parallel. And for the outlet, I used the small pieces of nail type pins and soldered a small wires on it. You can also use a banana sockets if you want, so I connected them tightly on these two holes. And at the positive output, I used a 5A22 Schottky diode. It mostly useful when we needed to charge the batteries. Then I covered the top with one more acrylic glass by using the same instant glue. But I suggest you to use a normal glue, because if anything goes wrong, unfortunately, we can replace it by opening the top. But that's fine until it blow up. And I also closed those two holes by a small piece of plastic so the air can absorb from only one direction through the heatsink. Then I used some screws to hold the fan tightly to the output of the acrylic glass. And now it's time to test it. So here we have to know that how much current does this small power supply can produce at the output. And all we have to do is to draw 3 amps from each module. So here, as you can see, that I'm using a high watt filament bulb as a load. And when it comes to 3 amps, I removed the multimeter and connected it directly to the bulb. And for the other module, which was connected to the USB socket, I used this bunch of 18650s with the Tp4056 module, which I was modified to increase the output current in my previous video. After connecting the USB cable, I decreased the output voltage to increase it slightly, because it may turn off the power if we connect it directly, and it only drawing up to 1.5 amps maximum, and whenever I try to increase it, it shows the exact same value. So the total output current of this mini power supply is 4.5 amps. And we can also increase it by connecting another laptop charger to this socket. It will be connected in parallel to the other one. And if you want to make a bigger power supply, then we should connect more of these laptop chargers in parallel, and also more buck converters to handle the load current. Or else we can also use a 4016 converter, which can handle up to 10 amps maximum, but that would be another video. After running it for a few hours, it was finally blowing a hot air that coming from inside the box. And if you guys wonder how exactly it absorbing the air through this hole, here is a small clip that I recorded to show you guys. Here I'm using a smoke stick, so as you can see how fast it absorbing the smoke, because there is no other holes that can pulse the air in. The rest of two holes that I was already sealed with a small plastic. If you observe it carefully, most of the computer power supply units have these small holes beside the heatsink, transformers and also small inductors, because these are the main component that gets hot. And the cooling fans are always being in the opposite direction to blow out the heat. So whenever I turn on the fan, the cool air that goes inside through the heatsink, so it keeps the heatsink cool and also both converters. And the adapter circuit was already connected below the fan. The heat will always goes to the upper direction, so it pulls more faster than that and cools the circuit as well. So that's my simple design to cool down the every component that gets hot inside with a single fan. That's all for now, and I hope you guys liked the video. Thanks for watching. Bye.